أمين وصلى الله وسلم على محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. The brothers وفقهم الله تعالى, may Allah سبحانه وتعالى grant them success. They have picked this topic of الدجال, المسيح الدجال, which is indeed a very important topic that every Muslim and Muslimah must have knowledge about him. And al-Masih al-Dajjal, no doubt, is from the worst trials and tribulations. And that's why we seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from al-Masih al-Dajjal in every salat. At the end, after the tashahud, we say, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min adab al-nar. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min adab al-nar. Wa min adab al-qabr. Wa min fitnati al-mahya wal-mamat. Wa min sharri fitnati al-masih al-dajjal. In the end, we say, and we seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the worst trial and the most evil of the trials, the trial of Al-Masih al-Dajjal. And there is no doubt, the greatest fitna that any messenger warned his people from, and the messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed us. He said, I have been given from this, from his description, means the description of Dajjal, that which no other messenger was given. That the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam had concerning the description of a Dajjal, that which no other messenger was given. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam likewise mentioned and informed us that the Dajjal would not appear until the people stopped mentioning him, and that he would not appear until the people would who make the khutbah, means they give sermon on Yom al-Jumu'ah, khutbah al-Jumu'ah, stop mentioning him upon the minbar. At that time we know that there will be appearance of a Dajjal, the false Messiah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will allow him to come out, to begin his reign of fitna, and to begin with his mischief of making, the like of which the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has informed us concerning. There was a hadith that was authentic upon the authority of Fatima bint Qais in Sahih Muslim, wherein she mentioned a story that took place in regards to one of the Sahaba, a Sahabi known as Tamim al-Dari radiyallahu anhu. Tamim ibn al-Dari was an individual, who was al-Ansari. He was from al-Ansar, those who aided and supported the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the people of the inhabitants of al-Madina. He was from al-Nasara. He was Christian before. He was an individual who was a sailor. And he mentioned to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam a story that had taken place with him that was so great that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam gathered the people for Salat al-Jama'ah, after saying, indeed, Tamim ibn al-Dari has just informed me concerning something that I had previously informed you of. So then the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam went on to inform concerning the story of Tamim ibn al-Dari. He mentioned that when he was a Christian, they were upon a boat. They were upon a boat that they were sailing, and the waves and the current took the boat, and they were on the waves, being shaken by the waves and being taken off course for a period of 40 days. that they were taken off their course for a period of 40 days. Thereon, after, they became shipwrecked upon an island. An island, they were unaware of it. When they came off to the shore, they had seen a sight that amazed them. They saw an individual who they referred to as a dabba, resembling to a beast. Resembles a beast. The front of him was not distinguished from his back because of the manner in which he was covered in hair. You can't tell the head or the tail. He was covered in hair to the extent that one could not distinguish the front of him from his back. So we said, who are you? What are you? So he said, I am Al-Jassasa. So they said, and what is Al-Jassasa? He turned to them and said, there is a man. And he pointed towards a monastery. This man was indeed is eager to hear from you. So they went to the monastery and they entered. And when they entered, they found a man severely bound by chains. Bound to the extent that his legs, from his knees to his ankles, was bound in metal. And likewise, his hands were bound to his neck, and he was tied up in this manner. So they entered and said, woe to you, what are you? So he went on to mention that indeed I am excited to hear your news. Who are you? So he said, indeed we are people from amongst the Arabs. And he went on to mention the story of how he became shipwrecked. So they asked again, and they mentioned again concerning the Jassasa, that they saw up until the stage that they had entered upon him. So they said, who are you? So he went on to question them, and they asked them concerning the date palms of Al-Baysan. He said, what is their condition? Do they still here bear fruits? So they said, yes, they still bear fruits. So then he asked them, so what about the lake of Tabariya, Tiberian lake? Does it still possess water? So they said, yes, it still possesses water. Then he went on to mention, it will soon not possess water, just as he mentioned concerning the date palms. Soon they will not possess dates. So then he asked about the spring Zuhar. Are the people still irrigating from it? So they said, yes. So then he said, so what about the Arab? What about the unlettered prophet that was sent among the Arab? Is he still calling? So they answered by saying, he's still calling and people are entering his religion. So he said, it is better indeed that the people, they follow him. As for myself, then I am a Dajjal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is soon to give permission to me to enter out to the people. And then he went on to mention concerning his leaving, and he's given permission to enter out. So concerning the Dajjal, we know that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has informed us of his presence and of his existence and all of the fact that he will come and create fitna, and he will be from the greatest of the fitan that mankind has ever seen. Concerning him, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed us. He said, when he comes out, he will appear in a place between Syria and Iraq. Initially, he will claim to be a prophet, calling to his prophethood. Then he will go on to claim to be Allah, subhanAllah. And then he will have with him from al-fitan a fire. And he will have with him a paradise. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed us that his paradise is actually will be the fire. And this fire will actually be the paradise. And he will command individual to enter into his paradise. And when they enter, they will find that it is the fire. And he will command people to enter into the fire. And those who enter from amongst the mu'mineen, the believers, will find that it is paradise. So it's the other way around. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed us that he is one-eyed. He is one-eyed. That one eye having skin over it. And mentioning that one eye will resemble a crushed grape. Like when you crush a grape, like that. And that he will have written upon his forehead, kafir, non-believer. Kafir. That will be read by every single believer, even if a person was unable to read. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also mentioned that likewise from his fitna, is that he will take a man and he will say to him, if I were to kill you and bring you back to life, will you believe that I am your Lord? And he will take that man and kill him and bring him back to life. And that man will say, now I am more aware and more certain that you are a Dajjal. That the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed us concerning. But in one of the varying narration, of the same hadith, just as to highlight the fitna, it will mention that he will cut that man in half. He will cut him in half. And in some narration, it mentions that it will cut him into small pieces. And that he will walk between him. Then he will bring him back to life. And that man will say that statement. And in some narration, it mentioned like the narration of Abu Umama. It mentioned that he will cut him in half and into pieces. And then he will turn to the people and say, look how I have cut my servant into pieces. And then watch when I bring him back to life. He will still claim that he has a Lord. That he has a Lord other than him. And then he will bring him back to life. And that the mu'mineen, the believers, will say, now I am certain, the mu'min will say, I am certain that you are Dajjal. That the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has informed us concerning. So if the Dajjal appears, then the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if the Dajjal appears, then go nowhere near him, because indeed he has with him from doubt that with which people believe in him. That shows you the danger of doubt, that we should be aware of doubt. And we should not even come close to the people of innovation, because they have doubt with them. They have shubuhat. And the hearts are weak. The hearts are weak. And no one can claim that they are Salafi and then they sit with the people of shubuhat, doubt. And then he goes to the Salafi and they say, well, I sit with those people of doubt because I'm giving them da'wah. Wallahi, this is deception. This is deception. Because in the end, what's going to happen to your skin? You're going to be affected by their doubt. It shows you that we should stay from the people of doubt, the people of shubuhat. Because the ilm is weak. And also, the hearts are weak. So shubuhat, we should stay away from them, the people of shubuhat. And that the believer will leave out, believe in him to be a Dajjal. Then when he approaches him and sees that which he has from fitan, people will end up believing in him from amongst the believers. And we seek refuge in Allah from that. Can you believe this? The person, in the beginning, he would disbelieve in him. But because when he comes closer to him, what's going to happen? He's going to be afflicted by his shubuhat and his fitan. And then he's going to end up, wal-iyadu billah, believing in him, wal-iyadu billah. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam likewise informed us that Al-Madinah during his time will shake 3 times. And that during that shaking, all of the munafiqeen, the hypocrites that were present in there will leave, men and women, and will follow Ad-Dajjal, wal-iyadu billah. Look at the fitna of Dajjal. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam likewise informed us that the Dajjal will be followed by the Jews, al-Yahud. He will be followed by al-Yahud, and he will have an army that will follow him from al-Yahud of Asfahan, The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, when he comes, then the one who is tested with his fire, he should recite the first 10 verses of Surah Al-Kahf. The first 10 ayat of Surah Al-Kahf. Naam. Therefore, be firm. And all praise is due to Allah, the Lord of Al-Alameen. Likewise, from the characteristics, is that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam informed us that the Dajjal will be plentiful in hair. He will have a lot of hair. He will have a lot of hair. And likewise, that which occurs in the story of Tamim al-Dari is that he was of a great structure. He was large. When he is followed, he will enter a person's village, a village from amongst the Bedouins, and they will disbelieve in him. And upon disbelieving in him, all of their livestock will die. Then he will enter another village of the people who believe in him. And upon believing in him, the skies will rain for them. Look at this fitna, wal-iyadu billah. Vegetation will come forth for them. Their cattle in the evening will come back fat, and their hips will be large. And their others, the place where you milk the cow. The others will be filled with milk. Fitna. Likewise, from the fitan is that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam informed us that he, the Dajjal, will have with him from the fitan of the dunya, that which will lead the people to follow him. And from the fitan likewise is that he will say to a man, if I brought your mother and your father back to life, would you believe in me? So he will say yes. And then the Dajjal will have 2 shayateen from the shayateen who will come in the form of that person's mother and father. And they will say, oh little son, follow him, for indeed he is your Lord. Wal-iyadu billah. Look at this. And then we have this individual, Ya Ikhwan, we have this individual. I don't know if we have them in Australia, but unfortunately we have them in some of the Muslim countries. They do this satanic work like this. They call themselves, that they call Tahdir Arwah. They claim that they can bring back someone. They can bring back the spirit to life. They can bring back the spirit to life. And what they do, they use the shayateen. They will talk to you and say, you know, to the ignorant, the people are ignorant, they go to them. And they say, you want to talk to your dad, you want to talk to your mom, the deceased mom or dad. And then he will summon the shayateen to talk to the person. And of course, the shayateen, they can mimic voices, you know? So when you hear the shaitan talking, you think this is your mom or your dad. So if someone doesn't have knowledge, so he goes to these individuals, because they don't have no tawheed. They have no aqeedah, sound aqeedah, no sound manhaj, no knowledge. So they go to them. Al-Imam al-Albani, rahimahullah, he mentioned that one of them in Amman, in Jordan, this individual, he claimed that he can bring back the spirit from the dead, you know? He can bring them back to life. Those who died, he can bring them back to life. And you could talk to them and the like. So Imam al-Albani, he said to him, I heard that you can bring back the spirit from the dead. He said, yes. He said, if that's the case, why don't you bring me back the spirit of Imam al-Bukhari, rahimahullah, because he's a scholar of hadith, and I have some questions for him. He said, you come the next day. So he said, when I went, he moved away. You see, this Dajjaleen, these liars, they use shayateen. And that's why, Juan, my sisters, Al-Imam al-Layth ibn Sa'd, rahimahullah, he said, if I see a man walking on water, I will not be deceived by him until I see his stance with the Kitab and Sunnah. Al-Shafi'i, rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentioned, he said, قَصَّرَ اللَّيْتِ. Layth fell short in this statement. I would rather say, if you see him flying in the air, do not be deceived by him until you see his stance. Kitab wa Sunnah. So this is a big fitna. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam informed us that before the Dajjal coming, there will be 3 years of famine. The first year, the crops. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will let the earth stop 1/3 of its crops. The second year, 2/3 of its crops. And 2/3 of the rain from the sky. And the third year of all of the rain of the sky and all of the vegetation of the earth. This is fitna, big fitna. And during that time, when he comes, the believers will gather themselves. And upon gathering themselves as an army, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise from amongst them Al-Mahdi. Al-Mahdi, that man who the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed us, his name will be as the name of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muhammad bin Abdullah, who will be from the lineage of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and who will, as the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed us, have a wide forehead, and he will have a prominent nose, and he will lead the Muslims and will bring justice to the earth during their gathering. The fight at Dajjal and those who are with him, al-mu'minun, the believers, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, will gather and they will fight against the Romans. An army from amongst them will gather and fight against them, a severe fighting, so much so that both parties will die, all of them. Fighting that will be so severe that even the birds will fly over that place. Those birds will drop dead because of the severity of that fighting. Then the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam informed us that they will gather together for the performance of Salat al-Fajr and after the calling of the Adhan. After the calling of the Adhan for Salat al-Fajr, they will go before the calling of al-Iqamah. And Isa ibn Maryam will descend. And upon his descent, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam informed us that he will descend between two angels, holding onto the wings of the two angels that will have reddish, and he will have reddish hair. Hair that will appear to be wet, although it is not wet. In some narration, it mentioned that it will have beads of perspiration, sweat upon his forehead. And he will have his head lowered. And then when he descends, he will raise his head. And those beads sorry, those beads of sweat will fall as though they were pearls. Then Al-Mahdi and those who recognize him will say, he will gesture to him to lead the Salat, Salat al-Fajr. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed us that Isa ibn Maryam alayhi salam will put his hand between his shoulders and push Al-Mahdi forward and say, indeed, it is a position that Allah has given to you. And as it occurs in the some narration, indeed, the Iqamah has been called for you. Then he will lead the Salat. After the performance of the Salat, Isa ibn Maryam will turn around and he will say, open the door. And upon opening the door, outside of the door will be a Dajjal. And there will be with him 70,000 Jews, all having with them green shawls, and all holding, brandishing decorated swords. And the Messenger of Allah informed us, Isa ibn Maryam will have with him a smell that if the kuffar, they smell it, they will die. Then when the door is opened and the army of Dajjal is present, the fighting between the army of Isa ibn Maryam and Dajjal will take place. And Isa ibn Maryam will race and chase at Dajjal. And when he sees him and confronts him, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he will melt, means Dajjal will melt. Similar to the melting of salt in water, he will literally melt when he sees Isa ibn Maryam, and he will continue to run from Isa ibn Maryam. Then Isa ibn Maryam will kill him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will kill him at the hand of Isa ibn Maryam. Naam. And that's the end, barakallahu feekum, of this lecture. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all al-ilm al-nafi' wal-amal salih walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. وصلى الله وسلم على محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم.